Hey guys, welcome back. This week, one of the biggest DDoS attacks in history occurred, a critical bug in Cisco routers will not receive a patch, a funny incident involving a threat actor trying to fund his startup using ransomware, and our CVE of the week, a heap address information leak vulnerability discovered in Samsung devices. The biggest distributed denial-of-service attack in history occurred last week. The Mirai botnet targeted an unknown entity in the financial industry, sending more than 17.2 million requests per second to said entity, making it 3 times bigger than any other DDoS attack in history. These volumetric DDoS attacks are designed to target a specific network and overwhelm its bandwidth capacity, often to utilize the attack to allow other forms of attack to be deployed. These attacks originate from malware-infected systems like personal computers or servers. In this case, they originated from more than 20,000 of these malware-infected bots in 125 countries worldwide. This attack was mitigated by the website security company Cloudflare, and luckily, Mirai botnet failed to harm the targeted operations. Still, this attack reached almost 70% of Cloudflare's average legitimate traffic for all their customers, raising concerns about the botnet's capabilities. In other news, Cisco will not provide a patch for a critical bug affecting 4 of their routers. Last week, Cisco revealed 6 vulnerabilities that were found in their products. One of the vulnerabilities that were found could allow an attacker to achieve remote code execution or cause an affected device to restart unexpectedly. This critical vulnerability affects 4 of Cisco's small business routers, but the company decided not to patch this vulnerability since the affected routers reached the end of life in 2019. Even though Cisco decided not to patch this vulnerability, they are looking to see whether it affects more of their products. We advise users to look at Cisco's advisory in the description and see whether they need to make changes in their routers. Moving on to some entertaining news. A threat actor tried to raise funds for his new startup idea by asking insiders to deploy ransomware in their companies. The threat actor tried to reach insiders in various companies by sending them emails asking if they could install Demonware ransomware on one of their company's computers in exchange for 40% of the ransom payment. The threat actor made a mistake when he sent emails to employees at Abnormal Security, an email security company. The researchers at Abnormal Security quickly responded to the email, posing as an employee that wanted to make easy money. The conversation then moved to Telegram, where the threat actor provided much information about himself, like his location and LinkedIn profile, allowing the researchers to stop his operations. This incident is quite silly and harmless, but there have been some more harmful cases where ransomware gangs used insiders to install ransomware in their company's systems. Now, for our CVE of the week. A heap address information leak vulnerability discovered in Samsung devices that was reported to SSD. This vulnerability affects Samsung's S10 Plus and S9 kernels that are based on Android 10. An independent researcher discovered this vulnerability and disclosed it to SSD through the Secure Disclosure Program. This researcher discovered that these two kernels don't properly handle information received from the user, as well as a memory leak issue in the CentOS and Red Hat operating system. These issues cause an information leak that can be utilized to gain insight into data addresses and function addresses, which can help attackers exploit code execution vulnerabilities. SSD reported the vulnerability to Samsung and waited for the appropriate 90 days, but Samsung hasn't released a patch fixing the vulnerability yet. We at SSD decided to publish this vulnerability at this time as the safety of our community is one of our core values and priorities. We advise you to have a look at the vulnerability in the description to see if you need to change your device. That's it for now. More details about what we just mentioned can be found in the description below. Don't forget to follow us on our other channels to keep up with the latest news and advisories.